Casey, welcome back to Epilepsy Sources and Accept Epilepsy. So we are in the month of November, and as you know, throughout the month of November, we always interview someone or the other. But before I introduce you to our epilepsy warrior of the day, our very first interview of November, a big shout out to Instagourmet, who have introduced their new peri peri powder. अब हमें पता है कि कोई भी खाना हो कभी पसंद आए ना पसंद आए तो हम हमेशा उस पर केचप डाल के उसकी टेस्ट थोड़ी बदल देते हैं, राइट? पर पेरी पेरी पाउडर अगर आप डालते हो तो टेस्ट तो वैसे भी बदल जाती है, भले कद्दू की सब्जी हो लेकिन उसमें पेरी पेरी पाउडर डाल दो, टेस्ट अपने आप अच्छा हो जाएगा, करेक्ट? So now let's head on to our interview of the day, and our warrior is Vinay Jani. So before we head on, I'm going to tell you something about Vinay. Vinay is an athlete, a father, a husband, and a cyclist. Plus, he has received the Golden Light Award of 2021. Yes, the IB Golden Light Award. So hello, Vinay.
Hi, Kirti. Thank you so much for introducing me and inviting me for the interview.
Yeah, starting our November interviews with you, an athlete. I always love people who are like, you know, into something which is different. Jo hatke kuch karte hai. I mean, I know aapka job bhi hai, lekin uske saath saath aap ek cyclist bhi hai aur ek dad bhi hai. Aur corona ke time full time to job thi aapki, being a dad.
Nahi, mera corona ke time mein mera office start tha, aisi baat nahi hai. I was working.
अच्छा, work from home था?
No, not from home. I was working from my office.
Okay. You're one of the ये people, unfortunate people जिनको office जाना पड़ रहा था.
Yes.
But आपकी cycling और ये सब कैसे? Well, we are going to get to that first. But let's start with our very first question. At what age were you diagnosed, Vinay?
I was 21 years old when I was diagnosed with epilepsy.
Okay.
And
yes, go on.
It was due to a cyst. In my left temporal region of my brain.
Okay. So उन लोगों के लिए जिनको cyst का मतलब पता नहीं है, cyst मतलब एक छोटा सा, can you elaborate it better?
छोटी सी अपना जो है आप गांठ बोल सकते हो.
हाँ, गांठ बोल सकते हैं. कभी कभार
नसों में गांठ बन जाती है जो कि कैंसरस नहीं हो.
यस, वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट. ये सिस्ट कैंसरस नहीं थी जो इनके लेफ्ट टेम्पोरल में है.
हाँ.
यस, तो इनकी कैंसरस नहीं है, इनको सिर्फ एक सिस्ट है, यानी कि एक गांठ हुई है जो उनके लेफ्ट टेम्पोरल में है. सो एट द एज ऑफ 21, व्हिच इज यंग, वेरी यंग, यू वर स्टिल इन कॉलेज, यू वर स्टिल स्टडिंग?
नो, आई स्टार्टेड माय ओन बिजनेस इन 2005, अर्ली 2005.
So that would be, how old were you back then? Oh, again, if you're not comfortable, do not.
Yeah, I'm completely comfortable. I was 21 years old that time.
Okay, so you started your business and you were diagnosed with a cyst in your temporal lobe.
After 6 months, I was diagnosed.
So how were you diagnosed as in? How did you come to know that you have epilepsy or there's a cyst in the brain?
Like many people ask. I've seen many forums that I'm having epilepsy, can I drive? I was driving that moment and suddenly I got a seizure and I had a very bad exit.
Okay.
Due to which, and after that, I had some more seizures, which my family noticed, my mother and my sister.
Okay.
So then they went for a consultation to a neurologist.
They took you to the consultation.
Yes. Then he advised MRI along with EEG. EEG was fine, but there was a cyst. He found a cyst.
So, continue. Sorry.
There were mixed opinions that some were saying it that you should get operated. Some were saying, no, it can be cured through medication. So this was a bit confusing part.
Yeah, don't we all go through that? So, what was the reaction from your family? I mean, you know, आपने अभी अभी business शुरू की थी और 6 महीने भी नहीं हुए and within 6 months of starting your business, आपका diagnosis होता है. So, and plus you're confused. Every person becomes a doctor at that point of time. And all the doctors take you to different directions. So
initially, yahi hua ki jo treatment hua, wo homeopathy se start hua. Homeopathy ne kuch mujhe benefit nahi kiya. Then I switched over to Ayurvedic. Aur usse bhi kuch benefit nahi hua. Then in 2008 December, I got a generalized seizure. Aur uske baad I got hospitalized. Aur 2-3 din ke baad I came into senses properly. Aur then mera allopathy treatment start hua. Aur almost 5 years मैं through medicines seizure free रहा और उसके बाद भी मेरा medicine weaning off हुआ medicine withdrawal हुआ और उसके बाद भी 1 साल मैं seizure free रहा.
So you were taking medicines for 5 years, you were on anti seizure medication for 5 years and you were seizure free for those 5 years, but then you again experienced a seizure. And when the medicine started weaning off, you again experienced a seizure after 5 years.
And yes.
After 6 years. Okay. After 6 years, you experienced yet another seizure. Yes. So for all the people out there, jinko ye jana hai, what is a generalized seizure? आपको ऊपर डिस्क्रिप्शन वहां पे ऊपर आपको नजर आएगा कि व्हाट इज अ जनरलाइज्ड सीजर. उसके बारे में मैंने ऑलरेडी बात की है और लोगों को ऑलरेडी पता है कि मेरा नजरिया होम्योपैथी और आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन के ऊपर कैसा है. उसकी लिंक भी आपको थोड़े टाइम बाद ऊपर नजर आएगी. सो यस, आपकी रिएक्शन क्या थी? लाइक what did you feel?
Personally, if I go like in 2005, it was not acceptable to me because seizures are uninvited guest. Wo kabhi bhi aa jaate hain and us time mein kya ho raha hota hai you are not aware of. Aap kuch bhi kar rahe hote ho, whether they are absent seizure, whether they are focal or they are generalized. So, उस time की जो moments होती हैं, वो आप completely disconnect हो जाते हो. आई वॉज बिट स्केर्ड क्योंकि मालूम नहीं था कि हाउ टू मैनेज एपिलेप्सी, तो वो एक बड़ा टास्क था कि नहीं कैसे क्या होना है. और मैंने उस टाइम वेट लॉस भी किया था. इन कॉलेज डेज आई वॉज 135 केजीज एंड आई लॉस्ट वेट. आई केम डाउन टू
I'm sorry, I'm interrupting you. Was the weight loss because of the medicines or?
No.
Okay. You like with proper exercise and everything. So it has got proper nothing exercise. To do with this. Okay. Yes, please continue. Sorry.
So it disturbed my entire schedule. Us time Delhi mein metros nahi thi, Uber nahi tha. So there were lot of ट्रेवल के लिए बहुत थी.
In 2005 there was nothing called Uber, Ola or anything. There were just taxis and rickshaws.
Yes.
And in Bombay we had BSP. Thankfully we still do. So Bombay is much more connected when it comes to public transport.
Yeah.
Than Delhi.
No, but now Delhi has become better in terms of transport. Thankfully to Delhi Metro. Yeah, you can go anywhere.
Yeah, I've been to like, you know, metros. My first metro journey was in Delhi, in fact. So yeah, we are diverting from the topic. Hamesha ki tarah hum baatein karte rahenge. For people who don't know that, we know each other over a lot many years now. Kitne saal?
Yeah, it's been almost 2 years now. Almost two years now.
But
my perception changed when I got discharged from hospital in 2008. I gained weight in the period of 2005 to 2008. And my neurologist said that I'm prescribing you medication which is not as per your body weight. Now it's up to you whether you want to increase the dosage of your medication or you want to lose weight.
Okay, so for all the people out there jin ko hindi mein hum patak se bol dete hain ki inke neurologist ne inko ye option diya tha ki hum aapko medicines इस प्रकार देंगे कि यदि आपको आपका वजन कम करना है या फिर आपको आपकी
दवाई का डोज बढ़ाना है.
दवाइयों का डोज बढ़ाना है. तो आपने कौन सा ऑप्शन चूज किया?
मैंने वेट लॉस का ही ऑप्शन चूज किया. तो घर के पास जो नियरेस्ट जिम था वहीं पे एक्सरसाइज करना शुरू किया दोबारा. और फ्रेंड्स वहां पे सर्कल था ही. वेस्ट दिल्ली में मैं रहता हूँ तो वेस्ट दिल्ली में रजौरी साइड काफी जिम है, रजौरी गार्डन साइड पे, तो वहां पे काफी कनेक्शन है. तो उनको मैंने बोल के रखा था कि मैं का ध्यान रखना स्टिल, क्योंकि अभी जस्ट दवाइयां स्टार्ट ही हुई थी. देन दे यूज्ड टू कीप एन आई ऑन मी व्हेनेवर आई यूज्ड टू डू वर्कआउट इन जिम. But thankfully, in those 5 years, I didn't got any seizure.
Okay, so when you were in the gym, you started gymming. I mean, of course, you had a high dosage of medications in the beginning. But at the same time, you were also exercising.
Yes. And
thankfully, you never experienced a seizure during those 5 years of your life when you were gymming.
Yes.
Okay. So what we already know that your epilepsy was developed because of the cyst in your temporal lobe. But what kind of seizures do you generally experience? Can you tell
generally,
us?
Generally, I experience these are focal seizures and these are called complex partial seizures.
Okay, so for all you people out there jinko focal seizures ya complex partial seizures ka matlab nahi pata, आपको ऊपर एक लिंक नजर आ रही होगी, उस पे जाके क्लिक कीजिए। मैंने ऑलरेडी इसके बारे में बात की हुई है। सो बिफोर आई आस्क यू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, अ बिग शाउट आउट टू आवर स्पॉन्सर्स ऑफ दिस वीडियो, दैट इज इंस्टा गॉर्मे। उनके प्रोडक्ट अमेज़न, फ्लिपकार्ट सब जगह आपको मिल सकते हैं। डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में मैंने उनके लिंक लिखी हुई है, तो आप वहां जाके बिल्कुल उनके प्रोडक्ट्स देख सकते हैं और खरीद भी सकते हैं। सो यस, मूविंग ऑन। और हाँ, उनके सिर्फ मैं अभी फिलहाल मैंने सिर्फ पेरी पेरी पाउडर पकड़ी है हाथ में, लेकिन उनकी जिंजर पाउडर है, अनियन पाउडर है, गार्लिक पाउडर है, देयर आर लोड्स ऑफ पाउडर। तो घर बैठ के कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस पाउडर डाल दो और खाना 5 मिनट में सब्जी रेडी। सो यस, कमिंग बैक टू यू विनय, माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज कि हैज एपिलेप्सी एवर बीन अ हिंड्रेंस व्हेन इट कम्स टू योर बिजनेस, लाइक व्हेदर इट हैज स्टॉप्ड यू फ्रॉम डूइंग समथिंग और यू नो जस्ट इन जनरल?
Initially, I would say, like, I used to overthink about epilepsy. So initially, 3 years, yes. But yes, after when I changed my perception and my thought process, I overcome those hindrances and those challenges.
So what exactly would you call a hindrance?
Like, I would say ki जनरली लोग सोचते हैं कि मैं ये काम नहीं कर सकता एज अ पर्सन विद एपिलेप्सी,
साइकोलॉजिकली,
बट आई वुड से एटलीस्ट गिव अ ट्राई। जब तक ट्राई नहीं करोगे आपको रिजल्ट कैसे मिलेगा?
करेक्ट।
सो यू हैव टू I would say आपको कुछ efforts करने पड़ेंगे कुछ result
पाने के लिए,
तो
कोशिश नहीं करोगे तो आपको कैसे पता चलेगा कि भाई
if you are thinking all the time about your challenges or your medical condition, you won't be getting any kind of result and it will lead you to nowhere.
Correct. So, were there times when you experienced a seizure which was so intense that you couldn't finish your work? Or
No, never.
Like you were always there. Okay.
Yeah.
So there was no physical hindrance, but initially you had some psychological, how to put it right, some reservations regarding epilepsy and accepting that this is something that you have to live with.
Yes.
Okay. So what made you change that perception? Like, what was that factor which made you change that perception? कैसे, क्या, कौन सा कुछ इंसिडेंट्स हुआ, क्या हुआ कि जिससे आपने 3 सालों में ये सोच लिया कि नहीं, आपकी उंगलियां नजर आ रही है, तो उन 3 सालों में, 2005 में डायग्नोसिस हुआ और 2008 में, अब सिर्फ 3 सालों में ऐसा क्या हुआ कि जिसकी वजह से आपने ये सोच लिया कि नहीं, लाइक कंप्लीटली मैंने एक्सेप्ट कर लिया है ये?
जब 2008 में मैं डिस्चार्ज हुआ हॉस्पिटल से और धीरे धीरे सीजर्स मेरे कंट्रोल होने शुरू हुए एंड आई सॉ अ टर्न अराउंड कि नहीं, अब चीजें जो है मेरी कंट्रोल होती जा रही हैं, आई कैन कंट्रोल थिंग्स माय ओन, I don't any kind of help या किसी का वो नहीं कि नहीं मेरे साथ चलो जरा किसी के लिए, then I thought कि नहीं, it's better to focus on myself और जब सीजर का रीअकरेंस भी हुआ देन आई मेड अ चॉइस कि नहीं, आई विल स्टिक टू माय टारगेट्स ओनली, आई विल नॉट डिरेल नहीं होऊंगा, आई विल स्टिक टू दैट ओनली.
So once you became independent, you earned that confidence, as it, you regained your confidence that you could do everything. Even though you had a relapse, even though you had, I won't say a relapse, it's not an addiction to have a relapse, wrong choice of words. Even though you did experience a seizure again, you did not lose your confidence. You continued having the same routine that you had decided you would. So how many years has it been that you have been seizure free now? कितने साल हो गए कि आपको seizure नहीं आया है?
After I would say 2015, I get seizures almost twice a month.
So it has reduced. It has reduced a lot, twice a month.
Yes.
Or has it increased for you?
No.
It has reduced for
you. Like in 2016, due to some reasons, I changed my neurologist. So every neurologist has a different opinion to control the epilepsy. So he or she will change your entire medication. Though that doctor had a very holistic approach.
The previous one? The one
no,
that you changed?
The one I changed. So I used to have a very open discussion. The first neurologist, I never asked any question about the AEDs, about the side effects, in fact, about the side effects of the AEDs. Generally, if we search about the side effects, we all know what Google says. Drowsiness.
Please, people, sorry, I'm going to interrupt you when I hear. भाई और बहनों, हमारे सारे दोस्तों, all the people who are watching this video, do not. For whoever state that you have faith in your parents, your children, the God that you believe in or do not believe in, do not Google anything, because Google will send you from a pimple to, that pimple might end up being a cancerous or contagious. So do not Google anything. Kuch bhi Google na kare.
Exactly.
For the side effects of AEDs, there will be a link up if you can see it. And do click on it and check out what are the side effects of anti-epileptic drugs or anti-seizure medicine. Yes, sorry.
But beside those side effects, which change our behaviors a bit, I would say a bit. There are side effects which takes toll on our vitamins, vitamin levels, our mineral levels, and other levels too in our blood. So he was very open on that.
That is like physically it takes a toll on us when it comes to the body structure.
Yes. So I will tell you one point. I had a discussion. When he changed my entire medication, I had an open discussion that why, since I won't be taking a medication name, because we are discussing about epilepsy and we both are not doctors, so it is not allowed for us to take a medication name. So I discussed with my second neurologist that why you are not prescribing me
the medication medicine
which controlled my seizures for a very long period. The best part about my second neurologist was he used to review blood levels after every 6 months.
Okay.
Entire, which includes complete blood CBC, LFT, KFT, vitamin B, vitamin D. So he immediately prompted that your salt levels are low. Your sodium level in your blood is low. And if I prescribe you that medicine, the side effect of that medicine is it will impact
keep on
your sodium level.
Okay.
And you will have electrolyte disbalance and it will trigger a seizure.
Okay,
so we used to have open discussion.
So, जैसे कि विनय जी ने अभी कहा कि अपने डॉक्टर से ओपनली बात कीजिए, जब उनको सवाल कीजिए कि क्या है क्या नहीं है, क्योंकि जब तक आप सवाल नहीं करते तब तक आपको पता नहीं चलेगा क्या होता है क्या नहीं होता. हर दवाई का असर हर इंसान पे एक जैसे नहीं होता. तो जो भी दवाई है एक्सवाइजेड, जिनका हम दोनों नाम नहीं ले सकते, उस दवाई का असर विनय जी के सोडियम लेवल पे हो रहा है, होता है. उनके सोडियम लेवल्स उनके बॉडी में से कम हो जाते हैं, जिसकी वजह से उनको सीजर आ सकती है, क्योंकि उनके लेफ्ट टेम्पोरल लोब में सिस्ट है. और सिर्फ उतना ही नहीं, हर एक का बॉडी कॉम्पोजिशन अलग अलग होता है. एवरीवन्स बॉडी कॉम्पोजिशन इज डिफरेंट, व्हिच इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाई दैट पर्टिकुलर मेडिसिन व्हिच वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू नेम इंपैक्ट्स हिज सोडियम लेवल्स. That does not mean that it is going to impact your sodium levels as well, because your body composition is completely different compared to either me or Vinay. Because that same medicine does not affect my sodium levels. So, and of course, our trigger focal points are also different. I have a lesion, he has a cyst. So it's completely different. तो यस, ऐसे मत सोचिए कि ये दवाई एक इंसान पे ऐसे काम करती है तो मुझ पे भी वैसे ही काम करेगी, ऐसे नहीं होता. बट यस, विटामिन डी की डेफिशिएंसी ऑलमोस्ट सबको होती है ड्यू टू द एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग्स और एंटी सीजर मेडिसिन. ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवन इज अफेक्टेड विद विटामिन डी डेफिशिएंसी. विनय, बैक टू यू.
यस यस, तो उसमें थोड़ी ज्यादा क्लैरिफिकेशन मिली, तो उसके हिसाब से फिर मैंने अपनी डाइट चेंजेस करने शुरू किए. नॉट दैट कीटो डाइट, टू बी वेरी फ्रैंक, आई एम नॉट कीटो फ्रेंडली डाइट. आई कांट हैव कीटो डाइट.
प्लीज 5 मिनट, लाइक 5 लाइनें हो जाए कीटो डाइट पे.
No, like keto diets. See, I had a word with some people who are in favor. Like some doctor are giving their children child a keto diet, but every doctor has their own way of treatment. So I can't comment on that, but. Keto is meant for, it is a high protein diet, and protein takes time to digest. And our Indian diet is more on carbs.
Correct.
So,
be local. Be local.
Yes.
Like for generations, so, we have been eating something.
So, like we eat rice, we eat wheat. So there is a difference between, we can't eat pork and lamb.
And that not in this climate. Not in this climate.
Yes, not in this climate. Like Anna, if you reside in west part of India, I reside in north. Though north is a bit cold, but how cold?
Minus
go, Ladakh and Kashmir goes in minus. Delhi doesn't.
But not as Siberia.
No. No. So it takes time.
Yeah, I mean, all of you know my take on keto diet. It's just a Ponzi scheme, and I have spoken about the origin of keto diet as well. You can see there are two parts. There were two videos made on keto diet, how it originated, how it was advertised in 1992, I think, to earn more money in America and everything. So the link regarding keto diet is up there, the part one. You can obviously check out part two after that. So yes, before we head on, a big shout out to our sponsors of this month, which is Insta Gourmet. And मैं पेरी पेरी पाउडर अपने हाथ में लिया है, इसका लाइट का शैडो आ रहा है अनफॉर्चुनेटली. यस, इनके बहुत अलग अलग तरीके के पाउडर्स हैं, जैसे गार्लिक डस्ट, अनियन फ्लेक्स भी है इनके. तो ऐसे नहीं है कि सिर्फ ये कहते हैं अमेजोन, फ्लिपकार्ट, बिग बास्केट, पेटीएम मॉल, स्नैपडील, इस पे भी आप इनके सारे प्रोडक्ट्स देख सकते हैं. दे हैव अ वैरायटी ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स एंड दे आर डिलीवर्ड पैन इंडिया. इंडिया के कोई भी जगह पे आप पूछिए, आपको इनके प्रोडक्ट्स जरूर मिलेंगे. इनके प्रोडक्ट चेकआउट कर सकते हैं आप फेसबुक, इंस्टाग्राम, और लिंक्स मैंने नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दी हुई है. So yes, when I'm moving on to my next question was, you're an athlete. Tell us something about that. But it's a two-part question. So मैंने दोनों सवाल अभी पूछने हैं. You cycle a lot, and how do you manage to cycle while, you know, I mean, you understand your auras, right? You realize, yes, your auras. Yes. So most, yes, people don't even know their own auras, or some people don't experience an aura. So how do you manage to continue cycling? Because logon ki cycle matlab ghar se market tak cycling nahi karte, ye kilometers like an athlete, ye professional cyclist hi
I'm not a professional cyclist, but yes, I do cycling for my own passion. There is a format of endurance cycling which originate from France, and it is called Brevets, or you can call BRMs. BRMs ka full form hota hai Brevet de Randonneurs Mondiaux. It is a French word. So,
उसका मीनिंग आप बता सकते
हैं? हाँ, बिल्कुल बता सकता हूँ. ब्रेवे मीन्स एंड्योरेंस राइड विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 200 किलोमीटर्स, एंड द लॉन्गेस्ट फॉर्मेट विच हैपेंस इन इंडिया इज 1400 किलोमीटर्स.
ओके.
एंड it is a cut off, like these rides have a cut off time. Secondly, the Mondiaux means randonneurs means a person who completes that ride is called a randonneur, and Mondiaux means of the world.
Okay,
so Brevet de Randonneurs Mondiaux,
the rider who can complete at the entire endurance cycling test throughout this world. Yeah?
Yes. Yes.
So, and have you done that 1400? I'm sorry I'm interrupting, but I'm very curious.
The longest I have done is 1000 kilometers.
I'm going to have a sip of water. 1000 kilometer maine sirf train mein travel kiya hai, wo bhi sote sote.
And I completed that ride in 74 hours.
Train bhi 1000 kilometer या 74 hours में कर देती है, लेकिन फिर भी 74 hours. So you did not sleep?
No, I slept. I slept. I eat. I took rest.
Tell us about it. How do you manage all of that?
These formats are self-sustained formats. Like in these formats, अगर आपकी बाइसिकल को पंक्चर भी हो गया तो आपको खुद पंक्चर फिक्स करना पड़ता है. ऐसा नहीं कि जो राइड ऑर्गेनाइजर है वो आके आपका पंक्चर लगाएगा. सो वी कैरी ईच एंड एवरीथिंग फॉर विद आवरसेल्फ
एंड
इफ यू यस एंड इफ यू फील हंग्री वी टेक अ हॉल्ट एट अ रोड साइड ढाबा, वी ईट समथिंग एंड देन वी गो.
Yes, but how do you manage when you're experiencing an aura? Because lack of sleep is the major trigger when it comes to seizures.
Major trigger. There is a term called sleep banking. Like normally, if I sleep 7 hours or 8 hours a day, so if I am thinking to do breve, so. Before breve, I don't do any physical activity. Before 2-3 days, I don't do any kind of physical activity. And I sleep.
What do you mean by not doing any physical activity?
I take complete rest from physical activities. And in spite sleeping for 7 or 8 hours, I prefer to sleep around 10 hours.
Okay.
To create a sleep bank for me. But aisa nahi ki, if we get time, we make sufficient window for a sleep as well during the ride.
I'm sorry, I'm going to interrupt you and ask you this question. And I'm extremely sorry for this construction work which is happening near my, like, right under my building.
No, it's okay.
So, you know, this sleep banking system doesn't work for every single person, and it's not necessary that it will work every single time.
Yes. Yes. I completely agree. So first thing, I would like to mention that I don't ride solo in BRM2.
So there are people who ride solo?
Yes, there are people who ride solo.
Okay.
So there are many people who ride solo.
What do you mean by you don't ride solo?
Like in my cycling group, there are many people who do this format.
Okay.
And I usually, and they know my medical condition, and whenever I'm riding with them, they keep my SOS medicine with themselves.
With them, okay.
And, okay, not, usually I also have my medicine, but they keep my SOS medicine. So whenever I feel my aura, since our shoes are locked in pedal, I immediately take a halt. I take a stop and unlock my shoe from the pedal. I can't stop my seizure, so let it happen. Then I take my SOS medicine, so to avoid any reoccurrence of seizure. And then we continue. All right.
So there must be when we were speaking over the phone, one of our phone sessions, you had spoken about energy tablets. Because I always tell people to carry energy bars with them, especially after a seizure, because our energy levels go down. So would you advise that energy tablet to normal, like, you know, people like me who do not exercise, or would it only be when it comes to athletes?
Kitki, like if I'm going for a 200 kilometer ride, so there will be a calorie deficiency. If I say approximately, I will lose calories around 3000 calories. So we take electrol, like energy tablets, which tablets you are saying, we keep with ourselves. Earlier, we used to take sachets of electrols, but it's hard to carry those electrols in our jersey's pocket. So now those have become compact. So we immediately have something after that. And we continue further. We always have something to eat and munch while, yes, while riding.
So people out there, jinhone काफी सारे लोगों ने, सॉरी विनय मैं सीरियसली बता रही हूँ, काफी सारे लोगों ने मुझे ये एनर्जी टैबलेट्स के बारे में सवाल किया था, इसलिए मैंने ये सवाल मेरे अभी दिमाग में आया तो मैंने आपको ये सवाल पूछा कि एनर्जी टैबलेट, हमेशा मैं लोगों को कहती हूँ कि अपने साथ एनर्जी बार्स कैरी किया कीजिए या ग्लूकोज बिस्किट, 5 रुपए का एक कूड़ा आता है, लाइक यू नो पैकेट ऑफ ग्लूकोज बिस्किट या जो चिकी होती है जो 2 रुपए में मिलती है, अपने हमें लाइक साथ में रखा कीजिए, ज्यादा पैसे हरे के पास पैसे नहीं होते। तो किन किन लोगों ने, चंद लोगों ने मुझे ये भी सवाल किया था कि जो एनर्जी टैबलेट्स नहीं निकली है वो हमने हमें हमारे साथ रखी तो क्या, इसलिए मैंने ये सवाल पूछा था। तो यदि आप कोई एंड्योरेंस स्पोर्ट कर रहे हैं तो वो टैबलेट्स रखना, इट मेक्स सेंस, राइट? आई मीन फॉर नॉर्मल,
क्योंकि वो उसको उसको सॉल्यू उसको जो है लाइक दोज आर वाटर सॉल्यूबल टैबलेट्स, सो दे नीड वाटर एट लीस्ट, यू कांट डायरेक्टली पुट इनटू माउथ
ओके। सो मेरे जैसे अगर लोग हैं जो एक्सरसाइज ज्यादा नहीं करते या फिर ऐवे घूमने आप गए हो, तो कृपया बस आपके पास पैसा है या फिर आपको शौक है तो एनर्जी टैबलेट्स ना रखे, खाना रखिए ढाबे पे, जैसे इन्होंने कहा रोड के साइड में ढाबे पे खाते भी है, ब्रेक भी लेते हैं, और उसी हिसाब से आप कंटिन्यू कर सकते हैं। देयर इज नो नीड फॉर एन एनर्जी टैबलेट इन योर डे टू डे लाइफ, करेक्ट? इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग,
करेक्ट
मी, यस। सो इन डे टू डे लाइफ देयर इज नो नीड, or even when you go on a tour like vacation touring, tourism, there's no need to carry that energy tablet. You can just carry the normal things that any human being should carry with them.
Exactly.
So before we head on, again, a big shout out to our sponsors, it's a gourmet product. So you can check them out. This is their Just Sprinkle product. So they have these two things, which is, one is just sprinkle, which is you sprinkle on top of your food, and this is healthy shelty daliya, jiske bare mein humne last time bhi baat ki thi. You can buy their products. Their products are available on Amazon, Flipkart, Big Basket, Paytm Mall, Snapdeal, and their Instagram and Facebook page link is in the description box below. Moving on, Viren, again, this is a two-part question. Has epilepsy ever affected your personal life? If yes, how? Like, you know, when it came to marriage and everything. And how did you manage it? Like, did you tell your wife up front? How was it? Like, if you don't mind sharing it with us, that is.
No, epilepsy has never affected my personal life. Like, I'm very open about my epilepsy in my circle. And later on, in after 2 years, like if I go in 2019, I become more open after doing my marathon, half marathon.
Okay. So you just...
I did my marathon in 2020 and I did my half marathon in 2019.
So the photo with Sachin Tendulkar is from 2019 or
20? No, it is from 2020, just before pandemic.
Okay.
Yes,
he has a photo with the god as his DP on WhatsApp. So, yes. So you became more open about it and you started talking about it after 2019. But, when you decided to get married, when your family started, talking about your marriage, you met your current wife. How was it? How was her reaction when you told her that you have epilepsy? Or did she already know what epilepsy is? Or did you have to explain it?
She completely, I explained her entire situation, that how my life is. And at that time, I was not pursuing endurance sport. I started pursuing endurance sport in 2016. So I explained my
hello.
Just a second. And she understood how the things are. And she completely understood.
Can you?
She's very open. Yeah, yeah.
We lost you in between. The last thing that we heard was that you told her and she understood. So
yeah,
did you
she
have
understood
to explain
the...
it to her, what epilepsy is?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, in India, it is you can explain a person diabetes very easily, but to understand a neuro disease, it is a bit difficult.
Neurological disorders are often mistaken as psychological disorders and illnesses as well, most of the time, not just sometimes, most of the time.
Yes.
And logo ko lagta hai ki aap pagal ho, lekin tantrik pranali ka vikar aur manasik vikar inme zameen aasman ka farak hai jo sirf Bharat mein nahi, halaki pure duniya mein log
in dono mein puri duniya mein
इंसान इन दो चीजों में थोड़ा कंफ्यूज हो जाता है, ऐसे कह देते हैं। तो काफी जगह पे ऐसे हमें सुनाई देता है, हमने देखा भी है कि लोगों ने अपने पार्टनर को, चाहे बीवी हो या हस्बैंड हो, उनको छोड़ दिया है क्योंकि उनको एपिलेप्सी है, या फिर उनकी शादियां नहीं हो रही है क्योंकि उनको एपिलेप्सी है। तो आपको ये अनुभव नहीं आया कभी ever in your life कि किसी ने रिजेक्ट किया क्योंकि आपको एपिलेप्सी है?
नहीं, she was the first girl I met and I immediately we got the things happened.
You're one of the very few lucky ones who met his the one pehle meeting mein ho gaya rishta pakka. Hum log jaise nahi hai jo abhi bhi dhoond rahe hain. But that is not because of epilepsy, that is because of being choosy, a bit too choosy at times, but yeah. But yes, it is, you're very lucky that she was very open about it, because there are people out there who do not exactly know what epilepsy is and don't wish to learn about it as well. So,
yes.
So, meeting someone who's open about it, who wants to learn about it, I'm sure she had to learn how to manage you experiencing a seizure as well. I mean,
yes.
How to handle you after the seizures. Not during a seizure, because nobody can do anything when a person is experiencing a seizure.
Yes.
So how was her first seizure experience? Because I know most of the people get really scared and then they don't know what to do. And it's very funny when we think about it in retrospect.
No, in fact, when she was the one, who was not satisfied with my previous neurologist.
Oh, okay. So she was the one who suggested you to change your neurologist.
Then, though she's not based in Delhi, then she searched a neurologist for me. And we met the second one.
The one you are currently with?
No, now I'm consulting in AIMS.
Okay.
Now I'm consulting in AIMS Delhi under Dr. Manjari Tripathi.
Okay. So before the one between these two, the holistic one and Dr. Manjari, the one that was between she was the one who initiated that you changed the neurologist.
Yes.
You are one lucky fellow. So, yes, as I already, like in the introduction, I told people that you were recently awarded the Golden Light Award. So tell us about it. What is IBE? And like, you know, tell us, like, brag about yourself. Come on.
IBE is like International Bureau for Epilepsy, and they work along with International League Against Epilepsy for epilepsy awareness. So, correct. Like, to be very frank, till 2019, I was open about epilepsy, but in a very confined people, like to my cycling fellows or my relatives.
You're close, but close-knit
very close network. So when I came back from Paris, I attempted Paris-Brest-Paris in 2019. That is a ride of 1200 kilometers, and in this ride the elevation gain is 12,000 meters, which is more than Everest.
So elevation gain ka matlab hota hai ki slope pe aapko
uthai utarna bhi hai chadhna bhi utarna bhi hai
matlab chadha पर उसके लिए लाइक उतरते समय ज्यादा ये नहीं लगता ना, पेडलिंग की ज्यादा जरूरत नहीं लगती ना, वो आसानी से डाउनहिल जा सकता है. अब फिर जाना थोड़ा मुश्किल है ना.
एवरेस्ट इज 8850. दिस द एलिवेशन गेन इन पेरिस ब्रेस्ट पेरिस इज 12,000 मीटर.
बेसिकली आपकी टांगों की वाट लगनी है अगर आप साइकिलिस्ट नहीं हो तो.
अगर साइकिलिस्ट पर्सपेक्टिव में बोलूंगा कि आपकी टांगों में इतनी वाट होनी चाहिए कि आप ना जो है इतनी चढ़ाई चढ़ सको. सो आई केम बैक टू दिल्ली और मैंने इमिजिएटली रनिंग शुरू कर, और मेरा कोई रनिंग का बैकग्राउंड नहीं था. और आई वाज रनिंग विद एडिडास रनर्स इन दिल्ली. And their coach, Nivedita Samantha, featured me after, when I completed my half marathon, she featured me on her Instagram story. Okay. And there is a marathoner cum blogger.
You were paused for a minute there. Yeah, there's a marathon and a blogger, marathon runner and a blogger.
By the name of Tanya Agarwal. She dropped me a message, And she asked me that, are you a person with epilepsy? I'm like, yes. So she invited me for a cup of tea at a place. And I had some common connections with her. So I went ahead, and suddenly after meeting her, I just had a feeling that since 2016, I'm doing endurance cycling. Like if I say I'm a super runner means a person who does a ride of 200 kilometers, 300 kilometers, 400 kilometers, and 600 kilometers. The cutoff time of these rides are 13 and a half hours, 20 hours, 27 hours, and 40 hours. Then he can call himself a super runner. So one of my senior rider in my group is a lieutenant general in army. So I had a word with him.
They have high endurance.
So I had a conversation with him. And I said, sir, I being a person with epilepsy, since 2016, I'm doing endurance cycling. And I attempted a ultra run, ultra BR, like after 600 kilometer breves, 1000 and above BRMs are called ultra breves. Like I've done ultra breves. I've attempted Paris, though I couldn't complete it. I couldn't complete that. I did a half marathon, but it's not easy for every person with epilepsy to do this.
It's not easy for any person to do this. Let's just be clear. Like not just a person with epilepsy.
There are many people. I know many people.
Because it's like the community, but you ask any Tom, Dick, and Harry, and they are not going to be able to do it. You have to like train for it any which way. So let's just be clear about this. Ki like kal ko utke ha maine ye karna hai. Aisa koi bhi utke bole.
You have to train for that. So I just had a conversation with him. So he immediately responded me. If in army a person gets diagnosed with epilepsy, because epilepsy is a medical condition which can happen at any age. Army doesn't
keep you in the army. They chuck you out.
No, they don't.
Wow, that's a surprise.
Yes, they don't check that person out from Indian Army. But yes, they will change the portfolio of the person. They will they will not give you the posting which involves arms and ammunition.
Right.
Because Army has many portfolios. So,
but they do not chuck you out.
No, they will not check you out. They will change the portfolio.
So even by corporate world people who you like, the HR folks who are listening to this interview, most of the times what happens is the HR person doesn't even give a chance to a person with epilepsy to have their first interview. They don't, and it is a fact. There are many people who are not given not just a field job, but they are fired from their job. They are chucked out of the company just because they have epilepsy. People out there, our army doesn't do that. They just change the portfolio. Of course, you cannot be on the border, or of course, you cannot be out there flying a fighting machine, like, you know, fighter plane, or you know, of course you cannot do certain things, because if you have a seizure, you're going to end up bombing or killing your own self or your own own side of the people. So of course you can't do that, but they would change the portfolio, they change the post. So rather than being an a-hole and chucking people out of your offices, which just make like your office is only making people sit on their laptops and chug like some numbers or something nonsense that you guys do. So rather than chucking people out, be more open to it. At least give them a chance to have their first interview. Vinay, back to you.
So he immediately said, start writing your experiences on your social handle. So I started writing about my experiences on my Instagram handle. Nowadays, I'm more active on Twitter. So one of my friend is a travel journalist. So she referred my profile to a senior editor who works for the Hindu newspaper. And I had a telephonic interview with that senior editor. Then she printed my interview along with my photograph. Then I got a chance to meet with Sachin Tendulkar just before this IDBI New Delhi Marathon. And after that, I started thinking on a serious track, no, that I should reach out more people. So I wrote a blog which got published in Living Well with Epilepsy last year and this year too, and this year in March. And recently I've submitted one more blog, like about the conversation with the doctor.
Okay.
That it should be more open.
I'm going to interrupt you again, and I'm so sorry for that. Inka Twitter handle or inka blog site hum description box mein dene wale hai. Chalega, right?
At Vinay Jani.
Yet you're still going to say like WhatsApp me the link. So that I can just copy paste it and put it in the description box below. So along with our sponsors, that is the Insta Gourmet, I'm holding their Peri Peri Sprinkle Just Sprinkle Powder. Along with their handles, we are also going to have Mr. Vinay Jani's handle, his Twitter handle, as well as his blog handle. Yes. So you wrote another article,
so,
The Conversation with Your Doctor.
So, the last year when my blog got published in Living Well with Epilepsy, I shared that blog with my neurologist, Dr. Manjri Tripathi. And immediately, I got a reward from her side that there is an webinar happening on National Epilepsy Day, which is on 17th
of November.
So I want you to be a patient speaker on that webinar. And this happened last year along with Sir Jonty Rhodes. So, and I said, yes, ma'am, sure, I will be there. So this was organized by Indian Epilepsy Association. Indian Epilepsy Association is
we are not associated. Going to talk about the association, moving on. We do not talk about Indian Association of Epilepsy Foundation of India and Indian Association on this platform. Yes. So
but more of like IBE and International League Against Epilepsy. They work for epilepsy awareness and betterment of person with epilepsy.
Yes, and they come to the, like, you know, tell us about the award.
And recently, I got awarded with the International Global Light Award.
Association nominated your name, and then...
Yeah. An association nominated my name, and I got a mail from IB that you are selected from Indian chapter.
You're one of the awardees.
Yes. So there were 19 awardees globally.
And you're one of them. So, hey, you've made India proud in a way.
Thank you so
much.
But there is a lot of work to do here. Still, there is a lot of work.
There is a lot and a lot of work to do when it comes to epilepsy. And we all know how much work needs to be done.
Yes.
Before we head on to our last question, किसी ने तड़का मारा है, शायद उन्होंने भी पेरी पेरी या फिर ऐसे ही कुछ तड़का मारा होगा. इंस्टाग्राम में जस्ट स्प्रिंकल इज आवर स्पॉन्सर ऑफ द मंथ, एंड डू चेक देम आउट. देयर प्रोडक्ट्स आर अवेलेबल एवरीवेयर, सो डू चेक देम आउट, एंड देयर लिंक विल बी इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो. So the last thing that I want something from you, okay? I really want something from you, and that is a few parting words, something that you want to tell the younger generation, the next generation, because the next generation is काफी confused है वो लोग life में in general. तो अगर epilepsy हो तो वो कुछ ज़्यादा ही confused हो जाते हैं. So, a few parting words.
See, I would say that don't be negative about any kind of circumstances. Sometimes you never know the negative circumstance become positive for you. So, always be positive and give it a try. That try will lead you to somewhere. And will open a door for you. So this will be my parting word for you, for the people, not for you, for the younger generation people.
Oh, I'm not that young, you know it already. Come on, don't make me say it over and over again.
No, no. Who said you are old?
Listen, when 20-year-olds hit on you, you'll feel that.
if I will say you are old, you will kill me.
No. I completely agree with you, so that these 20-year-olds stop hitting on me. I'm very happy being old, like whatever age I am. I'm very happy in my mid-30s. For all you people out there, I'm in my mid-30s and I'm very happy with it. I don't want to go back to the mistake that I made. So, you also receive questions regarding endurance when it comes from the younger generation.
Yes, I got questions from PWEs, sometimes about cycling. So, my first questions is like I immediately revert to them, what kind of epilepsy you have. Like I cannot suggest a person who is having a generalized epilepsy to go for a cycling, because first thing, in complex partial I'm having a movement of my, I'm losing my consciousness, but the movement is of my mouth only. Whereas
you
in generalized,
lose consciousness.
Yes, I lose consciousness.
Okay.
I lose consciousness, but I read my aura, so I immediately prefer.
You know, yeah.
I stop. So I don't know whether he know his aura or not. So I prefer. Start with walk, start, then graduate yourself, if you are able to, yes, you can walk 4-5 kilometers, then you can start yourself, then you can go for a running later on. If you think you are confident enough, that you can go for cycling. Because in country like India, where there are no driving sense, like you have to be very cautious while cycling. So right. Cycling is my last preference for person with epilepsy. Because when I started cycling, the person who introduced me, I outrightly rejected him. You know, I'm not going to cycle. I outrightly rejected the proposal that I won't be coming for cycling because I'm a person with epilepsy. Then he assured me that don't worry, I will ride along with you. Luckily, I got a company, a good company, and a good group. And more of, they all were into endurance cycling. And secondly, most of them were from army background. So they were aware how to deal a person with epilepsy.
And they know more when it comes to endurance in general compared to any person who just picks up his or her cycle and starts pedaling.
Yes.
Because like, they are from
endurance, I would say endurance rides starts from 100 kilometers. Okay. Endurance rides generally starts from 100 kilometers, but the BRM starts from 200 kilometers.
Okay.
So for 100 kilometers, it's not, if I say for a general person too, it's not easy to ride a 100 kilometer ride.
For any person, whether they have epilepsy or not.
Yes, you have to build that stamina.
Correct.
And you have simultaneously you have to nourish your body too while riding.
You have to train yourself basically.
Yes. And today in fact, since it's Epilepsy Awareness Month, I have signed up Brevet, which is happening from Delhi to Wagha border and back.
And when is it happening?
It is happening on 10th of December.
Okay.
And through this BRM, I will be generating fund for some NGO, which is working for people for epilepsy.
For all you people out there, you can finally buy this band as well, which is an epilepsy awareness band. And Vinay, you'll be getting yours delivered pretty soon. So
looking forward.
Yes, and more, not just the band, you'll be getting more. So to buy this band and to help us spread more awareness, so that, like, you know, fund us and so that we can spread more awareness throughout India. The description box of the shop link is right below. So, my God, this interview is going to have a lot of description links, more than the normal links. So, yes, just go. आप ये बैंड खरीद सकते हैं. ये बैंड खरीदने के लिए शॉप लिंक नीचे दी गई है. सो थैंक यू सो मच विनय फॉर कमिंग हियर. लाइक यू नो फाइनली पता नहीं कितने सालों से हम प्लानिंग कर रहे थे कि हम इंटरव्यू करने वाले हैं आपका, और फाइनली आज वो दिन आ गया और ये इंटरव्यू हुआ. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर सेइंग यस. एक बारी पूछ के आपने हाँ कह दी. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दिस.
मोस्ट वेलकम कीर्ति. द प्लेजर इज ऑल माइन.
थैंक यू. एंड फॉर ऑल यू पीपल आउट देयर, अगर आपको कोई भी सवाल हो एंड्योरेंस के बारे में स्पेशली, तो आप विनय जी से पूछ सकते हैं। हाँ जी हाँ जी विनय,
बिल्कुल
क्या
बिल्कुल
लोग अब
बिल्कुल
यस
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल एनी टाइम।
यस सो आप उनसे सवाल पूछ सकते हैं व्हेन इट कम्स टू यू नो ट्रेनिंग योरसेल्फ। और जस्ट बिकॉज आपको एपिलेप्सी है इसका मतलब ये नहीं होता कि आप एथलीट नहीं बन सकते। हमारे पास इसके दो दो उदाहरण हैं, एक तो विनय जी जिनसे हम अभी बात कर रहे हैं, दूसरे हैं आदित्य जिनसे हमने
आदित्य
यस द रिदमिक रनर।
यस
वी ऑल काइंड ऑफ नो ईच अदर, हम ईच अदर्स एग्जिस्ट। The epilepsy community is so small that all of us know each other. It's like a high school where everyone knows each other.
No, no, he's a good runner. Good runner too. Nowadays, he's like planning for a triathlon. A triathlon means, if I say a half format of triathlon, it means 1.8 kilometers of swim, 90 kilometers of cycling, and 21.1 kilometers of running.
Yes, he's like, we did discuss that in his interview. So, अगर आपको वो भी इंटरव्यू देखना हो तो वो प्लेलिस्ट में आपको जरूर मिलेगा, सो डू नॉट वरी अबाउट दैट एज वेल। पर कोई भी चीज करनी हो, यदि आपको एपिलेप्सी हो या ना हो, आंखों पे पट्टी बांध के उसमें कूदिए नहीं, क्योंकि ये ऐसी चीजें हैं जिसके लिए आपको अपने बॉडी को ट्रेन करना काफी जरूरी होता है।
और साथ के साथ बॉडी की नरिशमेंट भी बहुत जरूरी है।
यस सो ना जस्ट खाली भागते रहना है, उसके साथ साथ आपका खाना पीना रेस्ट सब सब देखना है, करेक्ट?
यस
सो यस, यदि आपको ऑराज आते हो, आपको आपके ऑराज पता चलते हैं। ऑरा का मतलब क्या है, आपको ऊपर लिंक नजर आ रही होगी। आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्पोकन अबाउट व्हाट एन ऑरा मींस and the different stages of epilepsy. You can see the link up there and you will know. So if you experience an aura, it's a good thing because even Aditya and Vinay both know their auras, so it helps them to stop. And Vinay, you like, I don't go unconscious normally unless there's something huge that has happened, and then like, you know, my focal ends up being into generalized, or then I have like, I lose consciousness or whatever. But generally I'm conscious, just not in control of my body. And of course we all forget what happens after a seizure. Like it's a daze. So that's fine if you're in a daze, people are there. It's normal. It's nothing out of the blue. But yes, thank you so much. We like, before we wrap up, a big shout out to Instagourmet. This is their Just Sprinkle range. They also have Healthy Shelty range, so do go and check them out. They have different types of products like garlic dust, onion dust. They have minced garlic. They have fried onion flakes. You just have to put them on. बिरयानी के ऊपर भी कोशिश की थी, क्योंकि बिरयानी के लिए हमको थोड़ा अनियन यू नो फ्राई करना पड़ता है, पर विदाउट फ्राइंग भी उसपे फ्लेक्स डाले गए थे एंड इट टेस्टेड गुड सीरियसली। एंड दे हैव जिंजर डस्ट एंड दे हैव लाइक अ लॉट एंड लॉट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स, सो डू गो चेक देम आउट ऑन फेसबुक एंड ऑन इंस्टाग्राम। एंड देयर प्रोडक्ट्स आर अवेलेबल ऑन अमेज़न, फ्लिपकार्ट, बिग बास्केट, पेटीएम मॉल एंड स्नैपडील। सो thank you so much, Vinay.
Most welcome, most welcome. Chalo. See you. Bye bye.
Bye bye. For all you people out there, stay strong, keep fighting, and as always, stay happy, stay golden.